In this video, I'm going to share how I built an app called Mind Your Bite entirely with AI. Yes, entirely with AI. I mean, almost. Let's start. I built an app mostly with AI. You can download via the link below in the comments and start using it immediately. Actually, it is far from being perfect and missing most of the features that I want the app to have. But this version does the basics, and I want to collect as much feedback as possible. First, let me share what this app is about. I had this idea in mind for some time now. When I was shopping in the stores, I was having difficulties understanding the ingredients in the foods and beverages I was buying. For example, I wanted to know if the product was gluten-free because I was not consuming gluten back then. And there was some period in my life where I eliminated any products that includes lactose because I was lactose intolerant. Another example was one of my children has acid reflux, which I had to eliminate acid in the food. And I wanted to know if that fruit juice had acid or not, because some fruit and vegetables were okay, whereas some others were not. Another example is that when I wanted to lose some weight, I didn't know which peanut butter was okay for my weight loss goal and which was not, because there are very different types of options. And even though it's the same peanut butter, depending on what else they include in that package or in that jar, that product can be extremely helpful for my diet goals and the other product may be totally off. I did some research and found out that there are already some apps available in the market, like Yuka, for example, but they are so general and not personalized at all. They tell the basics like what is the nutrition score or if they include sugar or not, but they are not personalized or custom to my diet preferences. So they were okay up to some point, but what I needed was a real custom solution. The moment that idea of an app started to be serious was during an event. There was a vibe coding event of Manus AI a couple of months ago, where we're supposed to develop something without any coding at all. And I just decided to work on this idea without even thinking much. In 2 hours of time, I had a live website which was doing the basics I wanted. It was scanning the product barcode and was providing me some insights about the product. Of course, it was far from being perfect or what I dreamed about, but having something real in hand that is actually working, even though it's doing only the basics, in just 2 hours without writing even one line of code, motivated me a lot to work on this idea further. After the event, I shared this experience with one of my friends who is a developer, and he also got very excited and wanted to be part of it. We started working on it more seriously, and in 1.5 months' time, we have the version available to test, to try. As I said, you can find the link below in the comments and try it yourself. Also, this is not a full-time project. We are just doing it as a side project on top of our full-time jobs. My developer partner is using AI intensely with the coding and technical part, but in this video, I won't go into the technical side, and I want to keep the focus on the areas that I work and walk you through step-by-step how I use AI on the marketing and user experience and building the structure of the app. In this project, I mostly use ChatGPT. And sometimes, occasionally, as an agent, I use Manus AI. And for design purposes, I tried Leonardo AI from time to time. But even for design purposes, ChatGPT mostly serves all my needs. So here are the step-by-step details of the process. Even before starting to work on the project, I used ChatGPT a lot. I brainstormed ideas, I asked for value proposition, differentiation points from competitors, and I even asked and brainstormed if the features I wanted the app to have are valid for the target audience. I asked ChatGPT to behave sometimes like a product strategist and sometimes like a McKinsey consultant. So I used ChatGPT as if I had an army of experts in my team. As there's already an app called Yuka, I was so focused on especially how to differentiate my app compared to Yuka. So I asked the value proposition and which features I should have that Yuka doesn't have. I want to share all the prompts with you, but I guess that will be so boring to listen all the prompts from start to the end. So I decided I will put them in a document. Please submit the form below and I'll send the document to your email. And of course, that's for free. Don't worry about that. In the process, I continued with creating a logo. So I needed the brand identity and logo. And again, I used ChatGPT for that. I also tried Leonardo AI for visuals of the logo to make it minimalist, emotional, and very approachable. At the end of the day, I used what ChatGPT created. So this is the last version that you're seeing on the screen. I'm going to launch the app with that. Although I know it's far from, again, being perfect, it is still okay. Until the app generates some revenue, I think I'll continue with that version. If you try the app, you will see that there are some cards and every title in every card and every text, every sentence you see there, I generated them with ChatGPT. So I just didn't put there the prompt and copied what ChatGPT created, but I really brainstormed a lot with ChatGPT on that. What I also did was asking many alternatives. So I asked 5 or 10 alternatives for each of my prompts. And even though I didn't like any of these 10, for example, I just chose the one that I liked most and wanted ChatGPT to reiterate with 10 more versions of that specific answer. So it was not like asking a prompt and getting the result and copying that directly to the app. It was more like a brainstorming process and work in progress type of workflow. I literally positioned ChatGPT or AI in general as a teammate or an intern on my team or some real person who is working on a specific area of expertise in my team. And if I don't like the idea, I ask it to improve it or to work on some alternatives. Then step by step, we come to a point which is closer to where I want it to be. And after the interface, the text and the logo visuals, there was a big thing that I needed to solve, which is the API of food database. Because I needed a database so that the app will check the ingredients, the nutritions, and compare these with my user preferences, which I chose at the beginning before I started to use the app. I asked for database alternatives for UK and Turkish markets, and maybe the US. I may include the US as well. And ChatGPT suggested me some alternatives. At the moment, in the current version, I work with Open Food Facts and also Fat Secrets for the UK and US market. I was conscious that I will hit some blockers with some of the products because I guess not all the products will be available in specific databases. And again, I asked ChatGPT to suggest me a solution in case a user can't find a specific product. And AI suggested me what I should do in this case. Now I'm trying to implement it. Although we haven't completed the implementation yet, we are working on a solution if a user can't find the product. With all that being said, there's one very important thing I want to share. I don't use AI only in the process of building the app, but I actually integrated AI in the app as a solution to the end user. There's an AI card which analyzes if the product is okay for their allergies or food preferences or religious preferences. We created a general framework where the app automatically assesses weight loss goals, allergies, ingredient concerns, and many more, and show the result in a color code score. Having said that, we have a big challenge there. because it takes some time for AI to analyze and come up with some results. As an end user, it may be a not that good experience to wait for AI while you're shopping. So I really want to improve that part before working on anything else in the app. If you have any solution for that, please share in the comments or approach me directly. You can find the email address in the channel. I'll really appreciate, and I'm very happy to try different alternative solutions. With that, there are also some other things that I work with the app. I have launched an Instagram account, and again, I generate images of this icon. We call this icon bite, and I create different versions of bites holding a peanut butter or shopping in the store with the help of AI with ChatGPT. And the text that I use while I post on Instagram or TikTok, again, ChatGPT creates that text. Of course, I review, or my team reviews, every single word in the text. So we are behind every text we put in the app or on social media. However, AI helps a lot to generate content faster and more efficiently. That's it from my side for now about this app. And I'll keep posting how it's going. I'll keep posting what are the challenges, and again, I'll ask for your suggestions. I really appreciate if you can share the ideas and suggestions that we couldn't think about. Please share if you have any comments down about this app, or if you have anything to share about the business idea or any idea that you are working, which you use AI intensely, and if you have any roadblocks or anywhere you got stuck, I really want to use this channel to support each other. So I'll try to reply and answer as much as I can. See you in the next videos.
I built an app with clever AI flair, no code, just thoughts and software air. From barcodes scanned to bites assessed, it helps you shop and pick what's best. With gluten-free needs and peanut plight, it was ChatGPT who was my guiding light. Each card and caption, a brainstormed delight. This side hustle journey feels more than just right.